One of the most common proofs that the Earth is not flat is that ships disappear from the bottom up going over the horizon. But have you actually witnessed that yourself? So this is exactly what flat earthers do. They confront people with that question, and when there's any doubt, they get their foot into the door. They then go on to explain that you can't actually see that far because of the Earth's atmosphere, moisture in it, etc., and therefore cannot be used as an argument that the Earth is a globe. So although there is some truth in this statement, it is not always the case. By applying the knowledge and techniques used in astronomy to wait for ideal conditions to do a difficult observation, the same goes for this. In this video, I want to share two experiments I did. One was to see how far I can follow a ship at sea, and another to test the effect of the change in height of a ship already on the horizon. The secret is to wait for ideal conditions. In fact, I had to wait more than a week and a half to finally get good enough horizontal transparency to make these observations. It turned out that my friend Johan Leroux's house is ideal for this experiment. Its great view, combined with about 40 meters elevation, helps to get you above the sea mist. Best of all is that Johan, being a radio amateur, is equipped with a system that can receive the AIS or Automatic Identification System radio beacon signals from the passing ships, a real-time local marinetraffic.com. This was a great help to know exactly when to expect a ship, how far it will be passing, its name, size, speed, etc., etc. Johan calibrated his display with distances. Each green circle is 10 kilometers, the yellow circle indicating the radar horizon for 10 meters above sea level, which is about 35 kilometers for his house. To record the observations, I employed my ZWO ASI224 MC planetary camera mounted on a modified 200mm f3.5 camera lens, yielding about 1.5 degrees field of view. The camera gets controlled with a computer via USB. This was a test shot pointed at a communication tower on the mountains behind my house about 8 kilometers away. Sunday, 27 December 2020 was a clear day with good horizontal transparency when Johan's system showed that a smaller cargo vessel, the Tanuous Dream, would be passing 30 kilometers from his house. This was ideal to set the focus and camera settings. Its four prominent cranes and bridge was clearly visible, agreeing with the online pictures from marinetraffic.com. When our real target, the 330 meter long Boa Steel Elaboration, clear danger point at a distance of 32 kilometers, my camera was ready to start capturing snapshots and short video bursts. It initially ran parallel to our position, but then turned slightly en route to eventually around Cape Point, gradually moving further and further from us. Just before reaching the 10-meter radar horizon, Boa Steel passed Tanya's Dream, as seen from our vantage point. The latter had since significantly shrunk in size, now at a distance of 37 kilometers. Not much of it was still visible at almost 40 kilometer distance. I kept following Boa Steel, taking footage every few minutes, showing how the hull keeps shrinking until just the bridge and the bow remained visible. At 40 kilometers, the French sailing vessel, Sodebo Alum, came into the field of view. By the time they crossed, only Boa Steel's bridge was visible, now at a distance of 43 kilometers. I kept following Boa Steel till nearly 45 kilometers when a foreground tree started blocking my way. By now, only the top of the antenna were visible. This fun animation was made by lining up enhanced snapshots of Boa Steel taken every 3 minutes, showing it disappear over the bowels of the earth. Conditions were even more perfect on Tuesday, 29 December, when the parabola passed at 30 kilometer distance. It was eclipsed by the tree about 10 kilometers further away, while its bridge was still partially visible above the horizon. A time lapse of its pass at 1 minute intervals. A shorter track of a subsequent cargo vessel, which had to be abandoned because of wind, showing the same behavior. I would like anybody to explain this behavior other than a ship sailing over the bowels of the globe Earth. Another observation I've been meaning to do for a long time was to photograph a ship on the horizon from different heights above sea level. Late on the afternoon of Monday, 28 December 2020, the 300-meter-long Boston was sailing past at 17 kilometers an hour at a distance of 33 kilometers. By the time we finished the observation, which took about 15 minutes, it receded to 35 kilometers, a difference of only 6%. According to Google Earth, the first observation was taken at 39 meters elevation. A fair part of the hull was visible above the horizon. Unfortunately, houses obscured the horizon for most of the first part of the way. It is only until you get to 23 meters elevation that the sea becomes visible for the first time again. It is quite amazing. From this height, the hull is completely below the sea, with only the bridge and bow sticking out. Next is quite a steep downhill to a dirt road at 17 meters elevation. From here, only the top part of the bridge is visible. The final stop is only 5 meters above sea level. Amazing, from here there was nothing visible of the Boston. It is completely obscured by an obvious bulge of seawater. Unless anyone has a better explanation to offer as to what we were witnessing here, I'll stick with the Earth being a globe. In fact, the time lapses clearly show these vessels disappear over the curve of the globe Earth.